Hi, and welcome everyone. Our broadcast comes to you today from the online outreach ministries of Faith Pentecostal Gospel Temple, situated in the cool hills of St. Andrew, Jamaica. Our pastor is Overseer Gwendolyn Reid, and our assistant pastor is Elder Dwight Reid. I am Elder Wilberforce, and we are so glad you could join us today. Before we go any further though, please welcome our praise team as they set the tone in praise and worship to our King. God bless you as you watch and listen in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. We give him all the glory. We give him all the praise. I want to declare to somebody this morning, hallelujah, that victory belongs to Jesus. Hallelujah. Victory is in him. Hallelujah. Yeah. Who can stand against the Lord? No one can. No one will. Who can stand against our King? No one can. No one will. Oh, oh, victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Him. Belongs to him. story. Come on, just sing it. You have won the victory.
Isaac, the God of Jacob.
Hallelujah.
Oh God, you're the God that said, let there be, and there was.
Oh, God Almighty, you are the wheel in the middle of the wheel. We just want to say thank you, Jesus. We just want to say thank you, Jesus, because you are good to us. Oh, God, we just want to say thank you, Jesus, Hallelujah. God, because Hallelujah. You are kind to us, God. Oh, God, we just want to say thank you, Jesus, because, oh, God, you deserve it, God Almighty. Oh, God, when everything else around us fail and when everyone fail, God Almighty, you never fail. Oh, God, and for that I want to say thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, you are worthy to be praised. Oh, God, here we are, God Almighty, standing in your presence, God. I pray, God Almighty, that you will bless this service, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, God, this service is blessed, God. The praise and worship, it is blessed. Oh, God Almighty, everything that will be done, it is blessed, God Almighty. Oh, God Almighty, may this service impact someone's life, God. May they say, God, that they will come to serve you, Jesus Christ. Oh, God, may this service be a turnaround in someone's life, God. Oh, God, may the songs, God, that will be ministered, God, that it will touch somebody. Oh, God, every testimony, God, every, oh, God Almighty, word that will be said, God, even the speaker, God, I pray, oh, God, that you impart, God Almighty, divine knowledge to the speaker, Jesus Christ. So, oh, God, the speaker can speak to someone's heart, speak to someone's situation in the name of Jesus Christ, that, oh God, the chains, the fetters, God Almighty, oh God, the obstacles that may be in the way, God Almighty, oh God, the struggles, God, that they're experiencing, God, that you will remove them, God, you will break the chains and the fetters in the name of Jesus Christ. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh, God. Oh, Jesus Christ, you are prayer, oh God, you are cries, God, and attend unto our prayers, oh God, this morning, God. I pray, Jesus Christ, God, that some yokes is broken in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, I pray, God Almighty, that, oh, God Almighty, some hearts will be mended, God, for those that are sick, Jesus Christ. Oh, God, that you will touch them, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. You will, oh, God, heal them, God. Is there anything that is impossible for you, God? Oh, God, no, there is not. Oh, God, we come to you, God, by your word, God. Oh, God, to speak your word over your people's lives in the name of Jesus Christ, God. I pray, God Almighty, that you will bless, God Almighty. Oh, God, you will touch every ailment, God, in the body. Oh, God Almighty, your word said, God, you were wounded for our transgressions and you were bruised for our iniquities, the chastisement of her. Oh God, our peace was upon you, and by your stripes we are healed, God Almighty. Oh God, your word said, beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in good health. Oh God, even as your soul prospereth, God. So I speak, oh God, good health over, oh God, everyone, God, that is watching this service in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, God Almighty, that you will bless, God, you will provide for them in the name of Jesus Christ, God. You will enlarge their courts and their territories in the name of Jesus Christ, God. Just as the woman with the issue of blood, oh God, she'd been struggling with it, God, for many years, but she pushed and she touched just the hem of your garment, God. There's someone that has been pushing, God, oh God, but today is their day, God, just to touch the hem, oh God, that they might be delivered from their situation, God Almighty. Oh God Almighty, there are some of them, God, that are trapped, oh God, in their very minds, God, touch their minds, oh God, speak to their minds in the name of Jesus Christ. Spirit of the living God, every, oh God, every mental health, God, I speak to it, God. Oh, God Almighty, I pray, God Almighty, that you touch the mind. Oh, God, because if the enemy controls the mind, he controls the thought process, and he controls the action, God. So speak to the mind, God. Oh, God, the mind will be subjected to your will and to your way. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh God, bless someone, finance, God. Oh God, provide for them, provide food. Oh God, pay the bills, Jesus Christ. Oh God Almighty, God, they will not suffer and they will not beg for bread. Oh God, I was young and now I'm old and I've never seen the righteous forsaken or a seed begging bread. Oh God Almighty, I come in the name of Jesus, speak, God. Oh God, into someone's life, God. Oh God, that the rent is paid, God. That the light bill is paid. That the water bill is paid, God. Oh God Almighty, that grocery, God Almighty, will be in the house. In the name of Jesus Christ, the internet bill, God, to do, oh God, schoolwork online, that is paid. Oh God, the children that are at home, God Almighty, oh God, help them, God, to even in this time to progress in their schoolwork, God Almighty. Oh God, it is Mother's Day. God, bless the mothers, God. Cover them under your blood. Oh God, the work that they're doing, God Almighty. Oh God, it is profound, God. It is phenomenal, God. Bless them, God, to be good mothers, to be praying mothers, Jesus Christ. Oh God, to pray over their children. To pray over their families, Jesus Christ. Oh God, continue to inspire them, God. Keep them, God. At times it gets so hard for them, God, but bless them. Cover them under your blood, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Have your own way, Father. Oh God Almighty, provide for them, God. Oh God, help them to be loving mothers, God, not just to their children, God, but to those that, God, that even need a mother, God Almighty. Oh God, bless them, God Almighty. Oh God Almighty, let them, God, be, God. Oh God, conduits of your love, God. Oh God, let them be, God Almighty. Oh God, loving mothers, inspiration, God Almighty, that they may steer children in the right path. In the name of Jesus, have your own way, Jesus Christ. Bless, keep, and cover, God. Oh God, what I feel of asking you, God, I pray you fail not to grant it, because you're the God that never fails, God Almighty. Oh God, grant our prayers, God Almighty. You are Christ, God. Oh God, I have your own way in our lives, God. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Well, today's lesson will be taken from Proverbs 31, from verse 10 to verse 20. And it begins this. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like a merchant ship. She bringeth food from afar. She raiseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household and portion for her maidens. She considereth a field and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hand she planted a vineyard. She blindeth her lungs with strength and strengtheneth her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. She layeth her hands to the spindle and her hands hold to this staff. 20th and last, she stretcheth out her hands to the poor, yea, she reacheth forth her hands to the needy. You are now a portion of God's holy word. We honor thy saying, thanks be to God.
Thank you very much, praise team. We are truly blessed every single week by your ministry, and we pray that God will enlarge your territory. Thanks to Minister Goodhart and Brother TJ for their respective parts as well. The world as we know it, saints of God, is going through trying times. There are millions of COVID-19 infections worldwide and hundreds of thousands of deaths. If you or a family member or friend have been affected by this disease, we pray your speedy recovery. If you have lost a loved one, condolences to you and your family. This is a time, saints of God, that we should be keeping in touch with our loved ones and friends. Someone needs to hear a word of encouragement, or better still, take some time to care by helping out where we can. Let's be our brother's keepers. It is our responsibility to do so. Today is Mother's Day, and today as we celebrate our mothers who are listening or are watching everywhere. You're watching from your living room, you're watching from your car, you're watching from, you're in the kitchen, wherever you are, we say Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day, special Happy Mother's Day to our overseer and the matriarch of this assembly. There's been no better example that could be set than that which our overseer has set. Kind, loving, compassionate, and giving. No better example. We have that example right here. By extension, I'd like to say also to Happy Mother's Day, special greetings to persons like Evangelist Wright is like the mother hen, I would say, of Faith Pentecostal Gospel Temple. Evangelist Fisher, they're women of God who never cease to pray. And if I have not called your name, it gets tricky sometimes in mentioning names. I know it. I know. However, big up on yourself, same way, because God knows that you have been phenomenal. God knows that you have been role models in your own right, and we thank God that you are one of our mothers today. God bless you. I know that after the word, you know, we'll be meditating and so on and so forth, but we have a special treat for you today. Our children will be celebrating their mothers, or the mothers of this church, so please do not touch that remote. Let the service play, let it continue to play, because we have a special treat right here just for you. By way of announcements, happy birthday to Minister Heather Wilberforce, celebrated on the 5th of May, Sister Sarah Morrison on the 7th of May, Brother Gregory Clark on the 8th of May. Happy birthday to them all. Sister Sarah, especially, you will hear from her. It's Child's Month, and at some point in the month, you will hear from her as well. We are using the opportunity this month to celebrate the children of Mount Royal. And so, we have some activities that are planned for the week of May 25th to 31st. All activities will be totally led by the children of Mount Royal, including our Wednesday prayer. They will be taking charge of the week's activities, which will end with Children's Church on the Sunday. And of course, we have some young, vibrant preachers, upcoming preachers. You can't afford to miss this. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Our speaker today is none other than our assistant pastor, Elder Dwight Reid. Elder Reid is married to Evangelist Norma Reid. They are parents of Daniel and Nathan. Elder Reid is a dedicated and humble servant of God, and I'm absolutely certain that you will be blessed by the word today. However, before we go into the word, sit back and be blessed by the praise team as they minister in Jesus' name.
And nothing can catch you by surprise. Overseer Gwendolyn Reid, the pastor and founder of this church. Greeting to you, Mom, wherever you are. in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and happy Mother's Day to you. You have done well in Jesus' name. Praise God. I want to also greet my wife of 28 years. Amen. I want to say to her, happy Mother's Day. I believe the children, both Daniel and Nathaniel, will agree with me that you have been a marvelous mother. Sister Norma, wherever you are, take a bow in the name of the Lord. Praise God. Shall we praise the Lord, everybody? There's something special about Mother's Day, and I've always said this, and I would like to say it again. When you compare the different mammals that God has created, you think of some other animal. Whenever that child is born, most of the time, be it a sheep, a goat, a horse, when that child is born, almost immediately, that young animal starts to stand and can fend on its own. Amen? But it's not so with a human being. When a human child is born, that child knows nothing. All they know is cry and you know what. Praise God. That's all they do. It takes a nurturing mother. It takes a kind mother to bring a child who knows nothing, amen, to great persons and to different people who do great things in this world. I want to salute mothers everywhere in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God. God is good.
Amen.
I want to greet every one of you that are watching on YouTube, and you have subscribed to our channel, and you're also like our Facebook page, and you're watching us wherever you are in the world. Greeting to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Happy that you are having church with us this Sunday morning. You could have gone somewhere else. You could have tuned into another channel. You could have made arrangements and be somewhere else. But right now, you're sitting and you're watching us, and we say thank God and we appreciate it. God bless you in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Glory be to God. God is an omnipresent God. In other words, there is nowhere where God is not.
Yes.
Shall I praise God?
Amen.
Someone said you take the wings of the morning,
yes,
and you find yourself in the deepest part of the ocean. God is there.
Yes.
In fact, it says if you spread your bed in hell,
yes,
God will find you there. Shall I praise God?
Amen.
There is nowhere that God is not. He is an omnipresent God.
Amen.
There are people going around telling us that, well, you know, God controls the heavens. He controls the heaven. But the devil controls hell. That's a lie. Even in hell, Jesus Christ is Lord.
Amen.
Even in hell, Jesus Christ is God. He is God everywhere.
Amen.
Just because he is God.
Amen.
Someone said, he is an on-time God. He is an on-time God. What I like to say, not only is he an on-time God, but he is a online God.
Amen.
Oh, you can't hide from him.
Right.
Shall we praise God? So I don't care if you're trying to hide somewhere in cyberspace. You may be trying to hide somewhere in your WhatsApp group or in your Facebook page or somewhere on YouTube, but God is an online God and he will find you. In Jesus' name, he's an unlike God. There's no way you can hide from God. His expanse is too great. He is God all by himself. Oh, praise God. You know, I'd like to engage you in the next few minutes on a topic that I will choose to call this morning, kick that disease.
Amen.
Amen.
Kick take that disease. Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, I did not have a base in biology. I did not study biology at school. In fact, I didn't like it. I felt that it was a very terrible thing to be killing the rats and to, you know, pulling them apart to see how they function. It was just a terrible thing. I did not do biology. It wasn't one of my favorite topics. But lately, this pandemic has got me reading and getting deeper into some biology, praise God, with the different briefings about this virus and the deluge of information that we have coming from pretty much everywhere. I was compelled by myself to do some research on my own.
Yes.
I read about viruses. I did some reading on bacteria. I tried to find out what those symptoms mean. I looked at vaccines, antibodies, and antibiotics. I read about immunity. And of course, flattening the curve.
Yes.
There are some things that I discovered in my little research, and I'd like to share some of it with you. There are some bacteria, and I tried to find out what's the difference between bacteria and virus. Always confuse me. So I understand that there are some bacteria that is good for you,
yes,
while there are others that can kill you.
Yes.
Bacterium is something that is much larger than a virus, and is really a cell that can somehow survive on its own.
Yes.
Praise God. I did my research. Well, I learned also that a virus is smaller than a bacteria, much smaller. In fact, the scientists describe it as a nanoparticle.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes, God.
And what does that mean? It means that it is 1/1,000,000,000 of a meter. That's how small it is. So in other words, you have a meter, you divide it by 1,000, and the result that you get, you divide it by 1,000 again, and the result that you get, you divide it by 1,000 again. It's a nanoparticle.
Yes.
It is virtually invisible.
Yes.
You cannot see it with the naked eye. Shall we praise God?
Yes,
that's a virus.
Hallelujah.
Unlike bacteria, I learned, a virus cannot replicate itself. It's a parasite.
Yes.
Shall we praise God?
Amen.
It needs a living host,
yes,
to multiply.
That's right.
That's where you and I come in. You need somebody living. Now, these nanoparasites attach themselves to cells and uses the cells to multiply. That's how they survive.
Amen.
So they get into your body, they hijack your cells, and use yourself to replicate itself. Shall we praise God? It's about making itself larger. It attaches itself to a cell and sucks it dry until the cell erupts and dies. That's what a virus does. Hallelujah. Like an intelligent army, viruses are specific as to what they attack. Some only attack the liver.
Yes.
Some will only attack the lungs.
Yes.
Oh God.
Yes, God.
Or any other part of the body. Think about any organ in the body. You can find a specific parasite that is designed in its DNA structure, praise God, that allows it to dominate a particular part of your body. That's how the viruses work.
Yes.
Praise God. You can't see them, but they're at work.
Yes.
Oh my God. But yet, some viruses prey on the young, while others on the not so young. So some viruses will wreak havoc with those over a certain age, and do not do anything to those that are much younger, shall we praise God. And then you have other viruses that do nothing to the older folk, but then the younger ones are at risk, shall we praise God. This is a terrible predator.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You can't see it, but it's a predator, always looking for a victim. Sometimes viruses even attack bacteria. That's how dangerous these little microorganisms are. Oh my God. And I learned another thing. I learned that when somebody is infected, the fever that comes about as a result of a viral infection is not a problem of itself. Because this is actually the reaction of your body as it mobilizes itself and try to fight off this enemy called the virus.
Yes, sir.
So when you have a fever, it is almost something good, because what they say to you is that you are alive.
Yeah.
If a virus attacks you and there is no fever, then there's something wrong with you, because your immune system is not working. But when you have a fever, it means that the body is at work. Shall we praise God? The Bible tells us that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. Hallelujah. Can somebody shout Jesus?
Jesus.
If you can't shout Jesus, type Jesus somewhere.
Jesus.
If you can't type Jesus, pick and say like in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. The most difficult enemy we have is the one we can't see.
Yes.
The one we can't see, or the one that we cannot identify.
Mm-hmm.
If you could clearly identify your enemy, you would naturally be able to strategize your response. Oh God. But when you don't understand your enemy, and worse, when you can't see your enemy, you are at a disadvantage already. Oh my God. When you don't understand what the enemy is doing, or when it is new or novel, that's what they use to describe the coronavirus. It's novel because nobody knows anything about it.
Yes.
Praise God. Every day you check, there's something new about this virus that you did not know. And I tell you, that's the worst kind of an enemy, when you don't know your enemy. It is best when you know your enemy.
Yes, sir.
Praise God. Otherwise, you're going to be having an uphill battle. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I'm not trying to make anybody in this building or in cyberspace, wherever you are in this world, I'm not trying to turn you into a microbiologist or a molecular biologist. I'm sorry if I bored you, but I had to get that out of the way. I understand, praise God, some of what I've learned in my research. Shall we praise God? But when I like to talk about a viral disease that we have been trying to eliminate for a long time, it's a long time this one is with us. Praise God. They have tried everything. With this virus, no vaccine can help. No microbiologist has ever created an antidote. It's the world's first pandemic. Oh God. It has infected doctors. It has infected health workers. Lawyers were not spared. Engineers were affected. Praise God, magistrates, presidents, and monarchs. It has even infected pastors and bishops. My God. No one is immune from this virus. It's called sin. Oh God. S-I-N, that's the virus that I'm talking about. I know you're concerned about the viruses that are going around now, but this one has been on our backs for a very long time, and we need to kick this disease.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Paul himself said that when he was trying to do good, hallelujah, evil presents itself. And the things that he knows to be right, that he should be doing, that he finds himself not doing, praise God, is because of the virus. They have been trying to quarantine this virus for thousands of years. But it appears to be getting worse. For every time you think you have it cornered, Anytime you think you have it contained, it pops up somewhere else. Oh God, praise God, it is like a dormant thing that's waiting on somewhere to reveal itself. It's called sin. The virus of sin that's trying to find somewhere to burst out. Oh my God. The condition of a sin-infected patient is serious. It has separated people in marriages. It has destroyed relationships. Yes. This virus has caused families to be set asunder. Oh, it has set father against son and mothers against daughters. This is a third virus. Praise God. Countries have fallen because of this virus. Empires and kings were brought to their knees because of this virus. It spears no one. It is called sin. Praise God. Friendships are broken up. Wars are started. Conflicts have progressed because of this virus. We need to kick it. We need to kick this disease. We need to kick this virus. Praise God. Now the funny thing is that this virus did not originate in China. It did not originate anywhere in sub-Saharan Africa or anywhere else in Asia. Praise God. You would be surprised if I told you where this virus started. Oh my God. In fact, it did not start in the Garden of Eden, as some people are thinking. Where did this virus start? Oh God. But of all the places, it started in heaven itself. Ezekiel 28 verse 14 says, "Thou art the anointed cherub that covereth, and I have set thee so. Thou wast upon the holy mountain of God. Thou hast walked up and down in the midst of the stones of fire. Thou wast perfect in thy ways from the day that thou wast created till iniquity was found in thee." I like to tell you that the devil wasn't on earth when iniquity was found in his being. He was in the presence of God, and somehow some strain of the virus hit him. Praise God, and ever since that day we have never ever been the same. Yes, this virus has been around a long time, but we have got to kick it in Jesus' name. I have always wondered how sin could have origin in the portals of glory. How did it start in heaven itself? Where did it come from? I may never understand in this world, but if the disease of sin could find itself in heaven, oh my God, can you imagine what it is capable of doing down here on earth? Almighty God, no wonder why they can't find a cure for it. No wonder why so many persons have been infected with this disease. Almighty God is coming a long way, but we have got to kick it. Sin is a disease, my friend. And unfortunately, we all contracted it from Adam and Eve as they sinned in the garden. It does not matter your race. It does not discriminate against your color or creed. We were born with this disease. Unfortunately, I like to tell you that your cute little boy or girl that was just born yesterday is already infected. Hallelujah. Praise God. Your nice looking grandma that I've told you how to live ever since you've known her, she's infected. Oh, mighty God, your upstanding father who has told you everything that he need to tell you as a young man and as a young woman to grow up and as live an exemplary life. He too is infected. Oh, my God, we need to keep this thing, because you never know when it is going to crop up, because of this innate and damning nature. Praise God, is somehow going to show us up the head somewhere. So we need to keep this virus. David acknowledged I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Yes, we are sinful, but we can kick it. One of the problems of a disease is that the longer you wait to deal with it, the harder it gets to kick.
Yes. Come on.
Praise God. The longer you wait, the harder it is to get rid of it.
Yes.
When it begins to take root and to control your body, it is hard to get rid of it.
Yes.
Oh, mighty God. But it's not impossible. Thank you, Jesus. That's why we need to kick it out of our lives. Praise God. Kick this disease out of our lives forever in Jesus' name. In my research, I discovered that there are a set of people that are described as asymptomatic. Oh my God. This simply means that a person can be infected with a disease but shows no evidence. They're walking around looking nice and fine, but they are infected and you don't know. Now, these people are dangerous because, oh God, the person sitting beside you could be asymptomatic. You never know. The person beside you on the bus that was fine could be asymptomatic. And you never know. And the symptom does that person nothing. But if you get it, it reacts with you differently. You never know. So someone who's asymptomatic is a very dangerous person. Praise God. They are dangerous because they can unwittingly pass on or disperse into your body a disease because they think that they are fine. I need to introduce to you another set of people. Well, they are called asymptomatic.
Oh, yes.
A-S-I-N-tomatic. Oh, my God. People are asymptomatic. You don't find them in the pubs. Or you're not going to find them in the nightclubs. Because clearly you know what kind of people goes to those places. You're not going to find them in the gambling den. Hallelujah. You're not going to find them in the brothels. My friend, thank you, Jesus. But you can find them beside you on Sunday morning. Because asymptomatic person looks fine, praise God. They come to church and they dress and they have a hat and they wear a nice floral tie. But they are asymptomatic. They are carrying sin around to infect you, but you don't even know it. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. So the asymptomatic person will sit beside you and they'll lift your hands to worship sometime. And I tell you that you will speak in tongues if you want them. Praise God. An asymptomatic person, praise God, they look real. But don't be fooled. They come with the gossip. They come with their backbiting. And because they wear a church hat and a nice necktie, you think they are fine. But watch the asymptomatic person. Praise God. These are the ones who come to the church. Praise God. When you think you are worshiping, when you think that they are fine, they are eyeing the sister on the choir. Praise God. When you think that they are doing the will of God, there is something in their mind other than what you think, because the sin that they are carrying, if you are blind, you can't see it because they are asymptomatic.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus. They come to fool your sister in church.
Yes.
They come to carry your brother wide. Praise God. And because you don't know that the sin is there, you get infected.
Yes.
We need to kick this disease. We need to kick this disease. Praise God. Praise God. We need to kick this disease. The asymptomatic person will come in and try to inveigle the brother beside you and tell them, well, you know what? I think you should be the pastor. Well, I don't think they're treating you well enough because look how anointed you are. Well, I think that you are the best singer and they don't even give you a song to lead. What asymptomatic person? You think they're fine, but they come with agenda in the work of God to turn the church around. We need to kick this disease. as the antidote. For we have an high priest, the Bible says, who can be touched with the feeling of our infirmities. You can't hide from God. He knows everything about you. He knows everything going on in your body. He knows you're up and you're down. He's God. And he knows every pain you feel. He's our God. Even before man was created, God already had his plan. Thank you, Jesus. The Apostle Peter said in 1 Peter chapter 1 that we are redeemed not with corruptible things, but with the blood of Jesus Christ, who was foreordained before the foundation of the world. So what are you saying? I'm saying to you that even before the devil was found with iniquity in his heart, even before the devil came and beguiled Eve and Adam in the garden, and sin took its root, God already had a solution at the foundation of the world. Oh, you can't hide from God. He knows everything that will happen before it happens. Praise God. He knows everything that will ever happen because he is God and he has prepared a place for you. You can kick the habit today. We have an answer in Jesus. They say, if you have a pre-existing condition, if you have a weak immune system, when the virus attacks you, it is going to have an easy way to get around to you. It can kill you more easily if you have pre-existing conditions. That is why we need to fortify ourselves against this virus. Oh my God, we need to build our spiritual immunity against this virus. Praise God. We need to fast. We need to pray. We need to get into the presence of God. We need to meditate on good things. That when the virus comes, we have an immunity to kick it. Thank you, Jesus. Don't wait until you have it before you start to deal with it. Praise God. You need to get some immunity in your system before the virus hits. Praise God. The virus is out to get you. It is out to get your sister. It is out to get your mother and everybody who you deem well in the name of Jesus. The virus is trying to tear us apart. But I come this afternoon to let you know that we have the ability to kick it. We have what it takes to win this battle against this unseen enemy. Hallelujah. The devil is coming like a flood, but Jesus is going to lift up a standard. If you can hear my voice wherever you are listening this morning, hallelujah, you could be in England, Grand Cayman of the United States of America. You could be in Germany or China. There is an antidote for this virus. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. I remember on the day of Pentecost, after Peter preached the word to the people that were there, they wondered in themselves after hearing the word that Peter spoke, and they said to themselves, "Well, men and brethren, what then shall we do?" Peter didn't tell them to wait. Peter didn't give them anything difficult. All he said to them is, "Repent, every one of you, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, because this promise is unto you and to them that are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call." Are you infected today? Are you infected today? There is an antidote in Jesus. There is an antidote in him. All you need to do is call upon the name of Jesus, because every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is the Lord. You have got to bow. Your mother, your father have got to bow. Presidents have got to bow. The devil has got to bow at the name of Jesus. We gotta kick this virus in the name of Jesus. We're gonna kick it. We're gonna kick it. Praise God. Don't let this moment pass you by. Hallelujah. You can start walking around with your infection.
infect itself. You need to know that the disease that you have is curable. The disease that you have can be cured. And the antidote is Jesus. Let's kick this disease for a better life. Let's kick this disease. Wherever you are, under the hearing of my voice, this is your time. This is your opportunity to make it right with your God. God has made a way for us that we can be cured of this that we have. No one on this earth, forget what I tell you about the Pope, no one on this earth can declare that they have not been infected with the virus of sin. But thanks be to God, we have got the antidote. If you're listening to me right now, I'd like to pray for you. Praise God. If you're driving your car, you could be on the highway and you're listening to this, just pull over to the side. If you're in your bedroom, just give me a little ear. If you're listening in your kitchen, just give me a few minutes. Father, in the name of Jesus, there is someone listening to me right now who needs an answer, who needs to be cured. Father, they cannot do it by themselves. The medication that they have been using has not borne any fruit. It seems like the disease is getting worse. But oh God, this morning I present you. I pray, God, that you will begin to move on somebody's heart right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That you will turn their lives around. That you will bring about a consciousness in their minds that they will make it right today. Talk to somebody now. Work on the sincere desires of their heart, Lord Jesus, and turn them around, because they need to be saved. They need to kick this disease. Thank you, Lord, for hearing my prayer today. I believe with all my heart, oh God, that there's somebody who has made a change, that somebody has decided they can't live out of the living any longer. And it's time to turn to Jesus. Have your way, O Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. God bless you, friend. God bless you. If you feel Jesus tugging at your heart, let him in. Let him in. And he will do the work. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My soul is truly blessed. Didn't I tell you that you would receive a blessing? Didn't I tell you that you would hear straight from God? And I believe today God has answered our prayers. The man of God has delivered the word. And if you are in need of counseling, if you're in need of prayer, we invite you to send us a message via WhatsApp or SMS if you choose to, or why not just call us? The numbers will be on your screen, or they will be displayed at the end of the broadcast. Please remember also to subscribe, like, follow, and share our YouTube and Facebook channels. Again, I just want to remind you that do not touch that remote. We have more treats in store, and we invite you to sit back, relax, and be blessed. God bless you, in Jesus' name.
Mothers.
A title of titles that carries and bears so many beautiful qualities.
That stems from being a caregiver, the provider, to nurturer.
The name given to those who have walked a path
that was not designed for the weak nor the frail.
But for those who know that on this path they should not aim to fail.
Mothers are heroes.
Who makes hard tasks look easy from the point of conception to death.
Mothers are burden bearers.
Who wipe away tears they too have cried.
Mother, one of God's finest creations without explanation.
To be a mother is to be phenomenal and brave.
Using all hidden abilities Jesus gave.
Mothers, you are a cut above the rest and just simply the best.
My mommy is simply the best. She cooks for me and she helped me do my homework and I love her.
To the middleman, so from your love, your mama never see your heart.